if your black man don't come off well at all, sisters, then where are you going?
Respected person in America is the black woman. The most unprotected person in America is the black woman. The most neglected person in America is the black woman. And as Muslims, the Honorable Elijah Muhammad teaches us to respect our women and to protect our women. And the only time a Muslim really gets real violent is when someone goes to molest his woman. We will kill you for our woman. I'm making it plain, yes. We will kill you for our woman. We believe that if the white man will do whatever is necessary to see that his woman gets respect and protection, then you and I will never be recognized as men until we stand up like men and place the same penalty over the head of anyone who puts his filthy hands out to put in the direction of our women.
If men are the maintainers of women, that doesn't just mean that you provide for them, you work hard and help them in certain ways. Men have the responsibility of upkeeping the spirit of a woman and upkeeping the nature in which she's created. She's born of the righteous by nature, and it is your responsibility to make sure that she stays in the mold that God intended.
Take a covert war on the black community through the woman.
Through the woman.
And he sees how that was done, and how we as men were not vigilant enough to fight for the women so that they did not play that game. After they took out the king, and then they took out the prince, take what I'm saying now, after they took out Mutt, then they took out Malcolm, they took out the king and the heir apparent.
Yes.
So there was no male to ascend to the throne, at least in the mind. Khalid stepped up to do that, but guess what? Okay? So now there were no men to deal with the queen. And so who moved in? Your CIA agent, covert operative, her name being Gloria Steinem. She stepped to the black women, and of course, we now know that Malcolm's wife, as well as Martin's wife, went boule. So all the time that we have been covertly taken down by the CIA. And we had a CIA operative working with our women, with Oprah, with all of our black women, and they now were given a bill of goods that they thought was going to help the people. It did not. We got worse. Bring her back into the fold where it is that we were as a family. Right now, we do not have a mentality of the warrior to go and do the fundamental things to get those sisters back. At this particular time, they are going to look at us like we did something to them, because remember, they are the problem staters. They state problems. They don't solve them. They acclimate, adapt, and adopt, and that's what the feminine principle does. She may think that she is in charge. She may think that she's solving problems, but that's because the society now has structured itself around her so that her problems can be solved by her, because all of the necessary fundamental resources are there for her now. But the resources are now owned by the state. The state has become the man, and when the state is giving her what she wants, it's giving her the impression and the perception that she is independent of anything else and does not need the man. So what you have to understand is that the mentality has been given to her that she needs to be independent.
That's your duty. But if you as a man are crushed and X'd out, who will maintain your woman? And since the nature of the Caucasian man is not to really maintain your woman, but to degrade your woman, then when the black man is destroyed, the black woman is a degraded woman, the color purple. You were a degraded woman in the movie. A degraded woman, a woman without a sense of value, of her own worth as a human being.
So those things that she told you I did to her, who else was gonna love me?
Africa's daughter is who she is. In the beginning was the black woman. Now we can't romanticize and fantasize that she is what she used to be.
Give me my take on it. And typically more black women have children at a younger age by different men out of wedlock. And it typically shows that when black women have families, their money isn't as low. Why is it that black women are so proud to run around and say they single, independent, and mothers? Had a woman argue with me today how she had three damn children by three damn men, and she was proud of it. You always hear black women tell you no matter how many fucking kids they got, no matter how much welfare they're on, and no matter how many days they spent in court trying to put somebody on child support and get money from them, they still will tell you everything is fine. Now, this is a big, huge pot of delusion that exists amongst black women. Now, this study by white people is telling you, you do better when you have a man there and you don't have all them damn kids, but you still run around saying it's all gravy. The rest of the world sees you for what you are. Now, I had a black woman say something to me. She said, black men don't have very much better of a view by the rest of the world.
And do a cold cock on this Prince William, get him out of your community like Khalid was telling you, and step up and grab your woman and bring her by your side and begin to start building a community with her. Hoodwink, but the problem is we can't get her to be convinced that she was hoodwinked. And when I'm saying what I said back in 89 that this was going to happen, everybody thought that first I was crazy, second that I was some kind of misogynist and woman hater. I said that you are going to be used as a tool, as a puppet, to undermine and destroy the black community as well as the family, unknowing to you. It's not going to be something that you're going to do consciously. It's going to be something you're going to be pushed into doing.
The financial situations of single women of color is so precarious that the study found that just one unpaid sick day or appliance repair would send half of black women into debt. And while marriage appears to basically alleviate some of the economic hardships for both men and women across the board, the data indicates that the positive effect of marriage on net worth is particularly amplified for black and Hispanic women. The report offers a number of possible explanations of the wealth gap, including prior and current institutional factors such as wage disparities and access to fringe benefits in the workplace, as well as a higher rate of targeted basically by predatory lenders. Also, you can add in the fact that black women tend to have more expensive loans and children.
But the problem is there's too many younger black women where all they want is the dog, all they want is the bad boy. All they want is the ignorant fool who sags his pants down his ass and gets multiple women pregnant. How can any woman in their right mind find a man like this as being attractive? But there's some women out there that look at men like this as being attractive. The problem is when you have kids with men like this, those kids are going to be raised without a father. This is the reason why there's so many single black mothers in the black community. Because they keep having babies with these ignorant thugs. They know damn well this man is not going to be a father to that child, but they'll have a baby with him anyway. And then they'll put down and turn down the educated black men that carry themselves in a respectful manner, that treat women with respect. They look at men like this as being nerds. They look at men like this as being cowards.
The most disrespected person in America is the black woman. The most unprotected person in America is the black woman. The most neglected person in America is the black woman. And as Muslims, the Honorable Elijah Muhammad teaches us to respect our women and to protect our women. And the only time a Muslim really gets real violent is when someone goes to molest his woman. We will kill you for our woman. I'm making it plain, yes. We will kill you for our woman. We believe that if the white man will do whatever is necessary to see that his woman gets respect and protection, then you and I will never be recognized as men until we stand up like men and place the same penalty over the head of anyone who puts his filthy hands out to put in the direction of our women.
Well, black women don't want to be happy. They squeeze out about 7 or 8 of them little nappy-headed children by the time they're 21. It's all downhill from there. Look, all that woman's body over there, that's a temple. A black woman's body is a temple of doom.
What you got? You're ugly, you're skinny, you shape funny, and you're too scared to open your mouth to people.
You're black, you're poor, you're ugly, you're a woman, you're nothing at all.
Don't nobody want you, don't nobody need you.
I should have locked you up and just let you out to work.
Man, the wretch that he was, but your anger, sister, your hatred was kindled against that father, that black man that you identified with. That's a no good thing. You never saw the slave master, the no good enemy that produced that no good nigga. You understand what I'm saying? So in the absence of your seeing the cause that produced this effect, then your anger and your hatred is focused on the effect, because the evil one threw the stone and hid his hand.
Yeah.
You got it?
He uses her, Whoopi Goldberg. She plays her part so well. I'm telling you, she may win an Oscar for that role, but not just because of her acting ability, but she wins an Oscar in the eyes of white folk because she aids in proving the point that the black man is a dog. I mean, if you look at the movie, it is a work that subtly is an indictment. Overtly is an indictment against the black man. And we can prove that all the way through to the end of the movie. Wasn't a black man in the movie that came off well.
Once your work is finished, don't watch the television. Once your work is finished, find something constructive to add to your mind. Have an hour for reading. And I don't mean read comic books. Read something that will make you know what's happening, so when you get in the conversation, you can sound intelligent, even if you aren't. Do you hear me what I'm saying? Why, what kind of man want a wife today who can't hold a conversation? No, don't a man want to sit up and talk to you about babies, or about Johnny needs some shoes? Your husband don't even want to hear that. One of the reasons you have trouble in your house is you can't carry an intelligent adult conversation.
Right.
And black women keep saying the same thing, and it's starting to bother me. It's like there's a playbook, and black women are all reading from this fucking playbook. And it's just saying, not all black women. If I never said all, then stop fucking replying to me saying it's not all. You dumbass, I never said all. Either address what the fuck I said or don't address me at all. You'd be a dumbass to believe that I said all, but then you dumbasses finish it with,
you can't make general statements, it's not all.
Let me tell you something. When I post on my motherfucking page and I say black women got the best bodies on the planet, I've never seen a black woman say not all. When I say black women are the most strong group of women on the planet, I've never heard somebody say, not all. when I put black women know how to deal with problems that other women just break down. I've never heard or seen a black woman write, not all,